Hi guys, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you all had a wonderful, wonderful holiday. And I hope your Christmas, however you spent it, however you celebrate it, I hope it was extra special and love-filled. I'm not gonna really talk about my holiday because I'll probably share a couple of pictures in a upcoming video. But I wanted to get this out to you all before 2019 because there's been a lot of videos out about everyone's favorites in 2018, and I know favorites are, for me anyways, favorites are the type of videos I like to watch because I like to see what other people really consider their favorites. So to me, I don't do weekly favorites. I don't even do monthly favorites. I kind of update as I go along. I just did my morning routine update. I just did my evening routine update. So a lot of my skincare products stay relatively the same. I am switching it up a little bit. So I'm not even gonna mention some of those products because some of them will be changing. But for 2018, this should not be a total surprise to you. If I were to go away somewhere and I could only bring something in maybe every category, or I could only bring a few things, what would I really bring? Because to me, that is really what my favorite would be. Number one, hands down, first off, would be sunblock. And this I started using, and I've used this for quite a while, and I still use it every day. Now, for some people, this will be too drying. For me, I do have to add a little bit of a face oil to it, but this is the Australian Gold Mineral Lotion Non-Greasy 50 SPF Botanical Sunscreen Face. I used it all summer long. It remains a favorite. Now, of course, as we get into 2019 and new sunscreens will come up, who knows what will happen by summer, what will be my favorite. But for 2018 and the tail end of 2017, this still remains, for my skin, my favorite. And I think when you talk about anti-aging and trying to slow down the signs of aging, I think your first defense on that is gonna be your sunblock. I really do. I have a second sunblock that I would bring if I was going away, and this is clear. So this is just the clear Neutrogena broad spectrum. This happens to be a 30, I also have a 70. So these would be the two sunscreens that I would pack because I would share this with Jay. The next thing that I would pack would be my toothpaste. Now, I use a toothpaste that is part of a multi-level marketing company. I don't sell it, although I've been thinking of signing up as an associate just so I could save some money, but I don't sell it. This is called AP24 Whitening Fluoride Toothpaste. New Skin, N-U-S-K-I-N. I buy it most of the time off of eBay or Amazon, and this is what it looks like. It has been a favorite toothpaste of mine and my husband's for quite a long time, so that is definitely, I would definitely pack that. The next thing that I would pack, and these are not in any significant order, I would definitely pack my, and you all know this, I mean, I hate to even mention it because you're probably so sick and tired of me talking about, but Retin-A. I mean, it is a big, big part of my skincare. So I would definitely pack my 1%. I still have some of my weaker doses, but my 1% would definitely come with me. Briefly, I buy this overseas in a pharmacy. I have set up a separate checking account that I just keep anywhere between $50 and $100 in there, floating checking account in that sense. I don't spend it on anything else. So I usually have a little bit of a balance in there, and I will buy my Retin-A overseas, my Tretinoin overseas. I buy the 1%. You have to pay by e-check with the one that I use, and I'll link that below. It's entirely up to you what you do. But for me, a tube like this is under $10 with shipping, where in the States it would be, in my area of New Hampshire, with my crappy insurance that I have, would be over $300. So you all have different prices. You all have different options for insurance. Some of you may get it free, and that's great. Mine doesn't cover it. So it is what it is. I buy it overseas. I also am in love, and this is definitely making my favorites, is my Olay Pro Retinol Eye Treatment. There is the US version and the UK version. I started this in February of this year on my birthday, February 14th. I've used this pretty well every single night and every single morning. I've missed a few, all depends, but pretty consistently. I put it, and I've talked about this, I put a dab here, and I just kind of tap it into my eyes around where my deep crow's lines are, my deep wrinkles. I was fortunate enough that I was able, I had company. Many of you know when I had a guest from the UK. She sent it to me before she came over, and I was able to start this shortly after I started the US version. Since that time, I've had a friend go to the UK and she bought me a couple. So this is definitely a favorite of mine, more so than the US version. There is a new version coming out of this. I saw it on Amazon. I've not seen it in any stores yet. It runs about $30. It has the exact same, from what I could see online, ingredients in the same order that the UK version has. So when I am out, I will try that because I really like, I shouldn't say like, I really love this. I will also tell you that you have to be patient with any skincare you use, whether it's Retin-A, whatever it is, you have to be patient because if someone says to you it's gonna be an overnight miracle, then it's a scam. Do not buy into that. There is nothing, in my opinion, that is truly an overnight miracle. Now, any kind of a system that you use, my Retin-A took me a long time to see results. The other thing that has made my favorite, and I am going to be doing a diet update video because many of you ask what I consume in a day, but this is not it. But definitely my diet has made my favorite. I've been on this diet since June, the end of June, and I have lost 25 pounds. The 25 pounds to me has been slow going, which is fine because I know there are people that can lose 10, 15 in a month. That's not me. So the 25 pounds since the end of June, I've had vacations, I've had holidays, I've enjoyed my life, I haven't felt deprived. Anytime when you're my age and you go on a weight loss program and you lose weight fast, it's gonna be really hard for you to see the effect of that, let's put it that way, to see the true effect of that, because your close friends might say, oh, you look great, but there's going to be one person that's going to look at you and go, you don't look all that great, you look sick. That's my mother. So slow going on a weight loss at my age, I think is so important because everything that we lose from our butt, from our body, we also lose from our face. And that means we get saggier and saggier and saggier. And I am a jowly person to begin with, so I'm prone to that. So that said, we'll do an update on my diet for sure, but this is not it. But my diet has made my favorites of 2018. I cannot tell you what an easy program this is. I mean, to me, to be able to be on a protein powder type of replacement program with all the nutrients I need and then have other supplements that go along with it that keep me full, that keep me motivated, keep me on target, and be able to cheat, go out, have dinner, enjoy a drink, do whatever I want to have and maintain my life is to me is awesome. And so my Isagenix, yes, multi-level marketing. And yes, just like my toothpaste, I did decide to become an associate. I'm not trying to pitch this. This is just sharing my favorites, what has worked for me. I love this stuff. The other thing that has, and should not be a surprise, is the collagen supplement. We date the bag. This one was open November 15th. You know, we'll probably, I don't know, maybe have another, I'm just guessing, maybe a month and a half, 2 months, and then we'll buy another bag of it. Jay and I both would not be without that collagen. He takes it every morning, every night religiously, and for him it's made a huge, huge difference in his joints and his ability to walk the golf course. That's how he measures everything, how he can walk the golf course. So it's made like an amazing difference for him. He absolutely loves it, and me too. So that is a must. The other thing that to me is definitely a favorite, and I've had this more than just last year, but it remains a favorite, mainly because it can also track my health, it can track my activity, it gives me notifications of email, it gives me notifications of voicemail, it gives me the ability if I want to surf the web, I can, is my Apple Watch. I love my Apple Watch. This is an Apple Watch 2. I would love to upgrade, but this is going strong, so I'm not seeing any reason to upgrade my Apple Watch. I don't know if you can see it turned on. I happen to like that face. You probably can't see it. But anyways, one of the things that I love about my Apple Watch is the ability to buy and change the bands as well. So this is just a band I got off of Amazon. Many of you commented when I have my pearl band on how pretty that is. And other times I have silvery bands. And I have probably six different bands that I change. I think that's it for my gadgets. I'm not going to talk about my skincare gadgets because that can be a whole different category. If I was packing going to a desert island, I wouldn't bring those my skincare gadgets as much. I might my spatula because that would fit. But this brush, if a hairbrush can be a favorite, this is definitely going. When I brush my hair with this brush, my scalp gets the most amazing, amazing massaging from my hair. This will take out sticky buildup of hairspray, of all that stuff. This is 100% boar's bristles. Very different than any brush I've ever used before. And I get this from my hairdresser. It's Supreme Ceramic and Ion. Olivia Garden, I think is the name, maybe. It's really a lovely brush. Definitely a favorite. It is expensive. If you want a $5 brush, this is not a $5 brush. It is very expensive. So the other thing that remains a favorite to me is my eyelash serum, Blink. I've talked about this. I used to use Careprost. I'm fortunate enough that I have a supply of the Blink sent to me. I've been giving it in giveaways. And I think it happened just because I talked about this product and how much I really love it. So I do think that sometimes you have to switch things up. I stopped using Careprost when I ran out. I went to another product. I didn't like it as much. At that time, I was contacted by Blink. I checked it out. I liked it. I talked about it in a video. I've been back and forth with them. The ordering process is difficult, to say the least, for most people. I have no problem with the ordering process because I do like an e-check and stuff like that. That's easy for me. But my Blink eyelash serum, definitely a favorite. If I was gonna go away, my skincare, I could wash with any kind of hydrating cleanser, preferably that I could get anywhere. So most of the time it is the CeraVe, which I talked about in my routine, but I can wash with anything, to be honest with you. Once I'm done that, I'm going to be switching out my vitamin C in the morning. I'm not gonna go back into my skincare routine, but I'm gonna be switching some of that out. Once I've done my serums, if I had to choose an oil, out of all the oils, I have carrot oil, I have squalene, I have a number of different oils, and if I had to choose one of them that I was going to pack, it would definitely be my marula oil. I get the marula oil from The Ordinary. This is 100% cold pressed. I really like this marula oil. I put it on my skin. I put it on my hands. I have been putting it on my neck. I put it on my hair. I love the marula oil a lot, so that would definitely go with me, and that would then bring me to my foundation of choice. Hands down, all-time favorite is my number 7 out of all the foundations that I've used. And everyone is different. My skin is different than yours, so everyone is different. But my number 7 Lift and Luminate in the color wheat. I would never have bought wheat. If I were to order this on the internet or just go in the store and look at it, I would never have bought wheat. But when I went to my local Walgreens, there was a salesperson there, sale in the cosmetic department, and she saw me looking and all that, and she recommended this. And I said, I don't know. Number 7, never heard of it. You know, I don't know. I don't know anyone that uses it. She says, you really should try it. She says, if your skin is dry, which is what mine is, this will give you a nice illumination. So she color matched me and said wheat was my perfect color. And I was like, sounded wheat? Nah, I was really kind of like, nah, I don't think wheat is any kind of a color match for me. But she did. She said, wheat is your color, so I bought it. I have not looked back since, I think it's been 2 years that I've been using this. And I have some high-end cosmetics foundations that I much prefer this. I have some Estee Lauder, I have the IT Cosmetics, then I have a number of drugstore, I have different samples that I got in Macy's. This is my favorite. So I would definitely pack that. I would also pack my number 7 City Lights Tinted Moisturizer. So the days that I wasn't going to wear anything and I wanted to have a little bit of an SPF, not much, SPF 15, but I wanted to have a tinted moisturizer, just beating around the house. I'm not gonna put foundation on. This has been perfect, perfect for me. I can't remember how much I paid for this. These are higher end drugstore products. I may have bought this at Target, I don't really know. This I usually buy at Walgreens. Walgreens usually has an amazing sale. Then we get to my concealer of choice. This is Benefit. I have been using this for a couple of years now. I really like this. This is a heavy duty, I call it my industrial my industrial concealer. This is a heavy duty concealer. I only use this to cover up or try to cover up some of my veins. I don't use this under my eyes. I don't use this anywhere else. I just for my area of veins. And then I always kind of use my Bye Bye Pores Translucent. This is the powder that I've been using from It Cosmetics. I really like this. It's translucent. I put it on. It kind of smooths out my makeup. I don't know. I like it a lot. So that's the one I use on that. That brings me to, oh, I forgot. Yes, because not a surprise, my face mask of choice that I would pack with me is my Be Venom. I buy this at TJ Maxx. I mentioned this before, and if I needed an exfoliation, if I wanted to do this, I do this every morning, alpha hydroxy face cream. Again, your skin may not adapt to this well. Again, another Walgreens drugstore price point. I would definitely bring that. For the rest of my cosmetics, out of all the eyeshadows I have tried this year, hands down, my favorite is still going to be my Viseart palettes. I have two of them. I have my Amethyst, which is probably my all-time favorite, but there's not enough colors in here for me to use consistently, as far as there's no brown bone, etc. So what I did is I have cashmere. I depotted my cashmere and I put it into this BoxyCharm Z palette that I got so that I can see it. So this is my cashmere right here. And I usually use these shades as my brow bone. This is a little bit of highlighter, and then I use between these two browns. Sometimes I'll go into the gray shade. So I would definitely bring this, and I would definitely bring my Amethyst palette with me without a doubt. And then I would do my Essence. I really love this color correcting essence that I have. I just dot around my eyes. That would go in my bag with me. And then that brings me to my lipsticks. The lip pencil of choice for me is the Avon Glimmer Sticks. I have many of them. I'm going to link Julie's channel below because she does sell Avon, and Glimmer Sticks are always on sale. This happens to be my favorite lip liner. I also use Rimmel lip liner, but I've never used a high-end lip liner, so I cannot compare it. I just use the Avon mostly. And then I will use typically a Revlon, a Maybelline, a L'Oreal lipstick. I have a few shades, so I would just grab one. I'm a layer person. I just put them on. I put different layers on, different colors. So when people say to me, what color is your lipstick? I'm like, I don't know. I have so many different colors on. I don't really know. But then I am a Buxom. Gloss is my favorite Buxom lip gloss. If I couldn't get the Buxom lip gloss, I would get myself the Hard Candy lip gloss. I have several of those as well. But if I had to pick one, Buxom, a much, much higher end. The Hard Candy is really, really nice, but still, my Buxom is my favorite. And that's what I would do. And then my brows, typically, I love the It Cosmetics Brow Power. And I lost the little lid is somewhere on the floor. And I think this is in taupe. So it's more of a universal color for me, and that's what I kind of will put on my brow. And then my favorite, this was sent to me initially for review, and I bought it since, is the Lancome Sourcil Styler. I love this stuff. This kind of really holds my brows in place. I really, really love this. And now, that brings me to my hair. This is Hayden, but this is Hayden, Henry Margu's Hayden wig. This is in a different color than the one I had before. So this is 88H. I'll link the information below. So if I had to, if I was going away somewhere, I'd be grabbing my wig, and I would probably grab this color because I like this color. Surprisingly, I was like hemming and hawing about this color, but I like this color actually a little bit better because the highlights are more platinum. Now it's a little shiny because I just got this, and this is directly out of the box. I have not really done anything to this at all, so I will probably do some dry shampoo, spray the dry shampoo on to take down some of the shine. But that, I think I have everything. But that's, I mean, I would pack my Henry Margu Hayden wig in one of the two colors I have, or maybe I'd pack both. That's just me. So, you know, my hair, my natural hair, you've seen it. It is thinning. It has been thinning for a while. I wear it up a lot, and I only would bring my hair clips so I could do that. But when you're gonna film, or you just want, like, I'm going to the store, I'm gonna wear this to the store today. I'm gonna wear it out. I feel really comfortable in it. I think it looks great on me. Yeah, I like it. That's my 2018. I think I have everything. Did I share everything with you? Yeah, I think I did. I mean, I don't want to repeat everything that I talked about in my morning skincare routine, so I do think I did. Look how natural that hairline looks. So yeah, but I am going to do the diet video. I'm planning on doing that on sometime the first week of January. So anyways, if I don't see you before the January 1st, I hope you all have a very, very wonderful, wonderful, healthy, happy, prosperous New Year. Here's to 2019, guys.